to the good soul. You know why?
Okay, so I can't use this because it won't let me rotate.
Van Halen just died.
Well, I...
Shit.
I'm live feeding right now.
What was it, man?
It's recording. Having a bit of technical difficulties, hang on. It won't let me, you're gonna have to hold it.
Won't let you what?
It won't let me use this.
Why not?
Because it won't rotate.
What won't
rotate? It's a live feed.
As my sins flow down the Jordan. Oh, I wanna come in.
Okay. So turn off.
I mean, maybe if I can stand it. Oh, you're gonna have to hold it.
3 hours.
It's not 3 hours. It's 1 hour. Okay. You want to go to this side or this side?
Wherever you want.
Do you want a bench?
Nope. You got 8 people here. You got 9 people here.
Hi, guys. We're having a bit of technical difficulties. I did have a fox eye and everything planned out, but it just snapped. So my lovely partner here, who's super committed to helping, is going to hold the camera and follow my instruction as much as possible. So today we're going to be redoing the skeletal design that I did last year. The first thing you're going to need for any kind of coat carving or creative grooming is to have your design ready. I just pulled up a skeleton structure of a poodle on Google, and it worked super well. And definitely have a dog who's willing to participate. Candy is a trained professional. She's been training since she was 5 weeks old to be a professional grooming dog. And as you can see, she's totally comfortable on the table. I'll try to get her to stand for us, but she's kind of fed up with me already. The tools you're gonna need is gonna be a clipper, cordless or corded, it doesn't matter. I would start with a 10 blade. You could switch to as short as a 40 blade, but only if your dog is used to it. Candy's been show groomed before. She has been shaved as short as a 50 blade. I don't suggest this for pets that aren't used to it at all. You're gonna need curved shears and straight shears and a really, really good tone. So for coat carving, you wanna make sure you get the detail as precise as possible. Candy up. Because we're not going to need any of the hair that's under here, I would start by shaving the inner side of the leg, and then comb it out. Touch. This way. Turn. Good girl. So comb it out, and then shave off what you don't need. Again, I'm going to use a 15. You can use something a bit longer if you're not comfortable yet, or if your dog is really wiggly. This type of grooming I wouldn't recommend for a dog who is not table trained, because they do need to stand still for quite some time to get as precise a design as you want. And I wouldn't force a dog to do it if they don't want to. So I'm going to look at the structure that I have here and kind of
get into the knee, which is when you bend the leg right here. Can't go. When you bend, hey, touch. I'm gonna do her face first because she can't see anything. This is the top knot that I've grown out since last skeletal design. I did have big goals for it, so cry with me a little bit while I cut it off. I'm just going to rough it in because we'll touch it up later. Good girl.
Lauren says next year you should do Bride of Frankenstein girl.
I'll do my best. It's hard to grow top knots, especially when you have rambunctious dogs that like to play a lot. Good girl. Okay, so now that her eyes are clear, she'll be able to work a little harder. Back to the leg. Swing. Good girl. So once that's shaved, you want to get to the knee, which is about here. So I'm going to just take it down. Already shaved her feet. She's a little bit naughty for her feet. She's not a super fan of it, so it takes a lot of treats and a lot of time. To me, it's important to continuously feed your dog treats during the process. You wouldn't want to work super hard and not get paid. They're the same way. So I'm just going to expose the foot and then be able to build the joint off of that. It doesn't need to be perfect at first because you're going to go back over it a lot of times. So it's really important when you're doing creative grooming to just be brave. Just cut into the fur, try it, shave it off, fur grows back, not the end of the world. When I started this design, I was super nervous. I didn't know what I was doing. I kind of just went for it, and it worked out super well. So we're going to kind of do that again today. Things that you kind of just get into, you start working on it, and when you're done, you're super impressed with yourself. Anyone wondering why I always have back pain? This is why. So to get the line in the bone, I take my curves and really just use the tip of it. I'll fluff the hair as much as possible. And then just go in a little bit. Pinch the skin, so always know exactly where you're cutting for that. And you can do a skeleton poodle without the intricate lines in the middle. I just like to challenge myself, and Candy's really well trained for this, so we have fun with it.
Samantha says you need to barter services with the masseuse.
She's a cat. I would love to creatively groom her cat, but I don't think Oliver would really like that. Okay, so our bottom joint, I don't know if you guys can see that. I'll make it smaller and smaller. It's better to start off with more and be able to carve more detail into it later than it is to just shave it super short. Like Candy's about an inch long right now. The last design I did, she was half an inch, but I figured a lot more with it. So there is a little knee joint here. So to do that, I just cut a line in downwards with my curves. OPAWZ has great curves. I'm using the Itsumi Super Curves, but the OPAWZ curves are pretty much the same. They just weigh a little bit more. I tried them with Linda Jonf and Christine. If you want to buy them in Quebec, you can buy them from Christine, or you can buy them from OPAWZ Canada. If you're buying from OPAWZ Canada, you can use my code Skelepoodle to receive 5% off. If you want to recreate this exact design, was made forever.
Can you re-say it?
The code is Skelepoodle, so S-K-E-L-E P-O-O-D-L for 5% off on anything on OPAWZ. And they have a kit with the dye and the crayons that we're going to use in the second live video. Hopefully I'll be able to duct tape my fox eye together so you can get a first person view, which is pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. find it's easier the second time around?
It's definitely a lot faster because I kind of know what I'm doing, kind of. Remember, I only did this once before. But yeah, having the image produced already definitely gives me a little bit more confidence. I've never done a live video, so I'm a little shaky and a little... Hopefully you guys get the gist of it and understand what I'm doing. Candy's been super patient and tolerant with me her entire life. Okay, for the hip, we're gonna land it about here. We could take the tail and follow the tail line up the back for all of the for the spinal cord, all of the vertebrae, however you pronounce that. So again, you just follow it. You can take a comb to be a little. You can line it like this to where you want to shave. I like to do it section by section, a small bit at a time, instead of just going for a big picture right away. I did actually follow her rib cage for her ribs. You can feel the ribs on the dog. So it'll be shaved to about here.
Carly asks if you can tell us about your prep process on Candy for today's.
So I, like, training-wise or grooming-wise? Grooming-wise, I washed, brushed, combed, shaved her feet, gave her assless chaps, shaved her bum area, the inside of the legs. And training-wise, I mean, she's classically conditioned to the click noise. She knows that once I click, she's getting a treat, so she'll hold a position until I click. She doesn't like these treats as much. She really likes these ones. And then she'll just stand there. But I've been training her classically conditioned. And I do force free attached to anything. Most of my clients aren't attached either. The only time I tie them up is when I walk away to take a picture or if I go to grab a tool. Like, the table's low enough that she can jump off whenever she wants to. She just stays because I have good food. Lazy.
She'd like to know what shampoo and products you use.
I use iGroom. iGroom De-Shed and Detangle for her, for most of my doodle clients. I use iGroom De-Shed Detangle. It's a great product. And I find really, really good results come even in doodles. When I do dye her with an oxidizing dye, so I don't bleach her. Animals, actually. When I do dye her with the OPAWZ Black to get the true black, it is an oxidizing dye, so I don't leave it on for long. And then I use the OPAWZ, it's an extra thick nourishing conditioner. I'll pull it up and show it to you guys in a bit.
She's asking what blade length is that, Larissa?
This is a 15.
precise line in what you're carving. You can comb everything down and then cut into it. And you'll end up with a sharper edge.
Samantha asks, how tired is Candy after standing up for a session like this? Will she be exhausted? This is a lot of patience for her.
No, Candy's one of those dogs who gets the zoomies as soon as you stop doing anything, really. I'm not sure what it is about her. She was diagnosed with idiopathic epilepsy when she was 9 months old, and then she started taking a bunch of medication during her developmental phases. I'm not entirely sure why she behaves the way she does, but she does get the zoomies when she is tired. We'll go for long walks, and then as soon as we get to the house and unleash her, she gets the zoomies around the house. Sometimes she gets overboard and will turn and attack one of our dogs. But for grooming, she's as peaceful and calm as she ever could be. People don't even believe that it's the same dog when they see her on the table versus on the floor running around the house. But yeah, after we groom for about a 2-hour session, she'll get the zoomies, she'll play like crazy, and then she'll go to sleep. I don't groom her for more than 2 hours. I do give her a lot of breaks. Like if I see she won't get up when I'm asking her to get up, then I'll work on something so that she can lay down and rest a bit. I do use yoga mats so they don't get fatigued. But yeah, I won't do a full skeleton. The last design took me about 8 hours, and I broke it up into about 7 hours per week. Dyeing is the last process. I'll trim one side and then trim the other side another day, and then finish one side of the front one day and then another side the other day. Depending on her, I mean, some days she just doesn't want to participate. Some days she's just like, I'm not getting on the table. It's rare, but it does happen. And then that day we won't be able to groom. Oh. Okay, touch. So we'll work on her face since she's being exhausted about her bum. For the skeleton eyes, I did not use dye. I used the OPAWZ paint pen in black. If you wet them just a little bit, you can get a really, really thick result. So on darker dogs or on jet black that you're trying to put on white, because the fur does move and it does look a little see-through and it doesn't look as great, you can definitely dip them in water. For her eyes, the saddest part, sad for us groomers who love to keep hair, is I shaved around her eyes and it took about 6 months for it to grow back to a normal length. But she does have allergies in the fall, just like me. That's why you see this tear staining. She does chew on her feet, and you do see the eye tear stains. The rest of the year, that's not there. You don't want to shave off too much, just enough that it looks like the hole that the eye would go into. You. This is my toe blade. It is a 40 blade. And he's used to being shaved with 40s and 50s for the show ring. So her skin isn't super sensitive. I wouldn't use as short a blade on a client dog. And right on top of the nose, come. Right on top of the nose, you just do the little triangle that you see on all skeletons. And again, super sad because it takes so long for that to grow back. But it always grows back super healthy. I've never had an issue with Candy. When she gets impatient and annoyed with me, she taps her feet like a skunk. But like impatient because I'm taking too long to feed her treats. Okay, mouth. Good. Up. Good girl. And I'm holding her face, but I'm not putting much pressure. I'm not pulling her around or anything like that. She's just, her whiskers are there, so she feels me. For this, I'm just gonna trim all this hair here off with my super curves. Good shake.
She's like,
So in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, there's not that many clients who want crazy extreme creative groomings. So I haven't really charged anyone for designs this intricate. Usually it's just like ears, tail, something cute. And I do charge hourly and then just add the cost of product on top of that. But again, always make sure that the dogs are actually okay with being creatively groomed. Some dogs don't like to go in the bath, they don't like to be wet. I wouldn't recommend trying to push those dogs through this much grooming. If you want to make a line a little more precise, you can switch your blade to 40, and then you just touch the line. You don't even brush or pull, you just touch and comb. And then touch it again. What we do for spirals and stuff like that, once we have our lines cut in, we do pass over with the clipper just to make sure it's as clean a line as possible. Like I said, you're going to be going over it a lot of times to get the look that you want. For the purposes of this video, I'll kind of just zoom through it and then touch it up later. Unless you guys want to spend like 4 hours in a live video, which I'm sure Candy doesn't want to do that, and I can guarantee you the cameraman does not want to do that. We basically have one leg done. We'll make it smaller and go over and detail it a lot more later, but you have the gist of it. That's the hip bone, and the thigh bone, and then the watch bone, and then the leg bones. Good. We're gonna move to the tail now and start carving out the spinal cord, because I really want you guys to see that process. It's pretty cool. The dog could sit or stand for it. It doesn't really matter. Got fur in her eye, let me get it. Good girl. When I found OPAWZ, I really did look up all the ingredients, and I do appreciate them, because if you ask any of their representatives, they will send you the full detailed ingredient list so you can look it up. Because Candy had idiopathic epilepsy, I say had because it's been over a year, she's off of medication after thousands of dollars spent. As you can see, she's living the best quality of life she could live, but you can't give things that are toxic in the slightest amount. Like, she can't have flea medication. And she can't have flea medication because there is neurotoxins in it. So I needed to really make sure that it was a product that wasn't going to harm her brain. And OPAWZ is super fun, super easy to use. I'm sure there's other products out there. This is just the one that I use and I know of. She's gonna get into zoomy mode soon, so we don't have much time before she is over it and wants to play. This way. This way. Good. Good. And she recently had a abscess on her anal gland weeks ago when we got home from the but she's all good and healed now. You can see the vet shaved a little shorter than I'm shaving. So make sure it's all brushed out super, super well. I'm gonna use this blade. And then comb it. You can make each vertebrae as big, round, short, flat to you and what your dog can tolerate. So the base of the tail is here, I already have that shaved. So I'm gonna shave the same around. Candy's going to town licking the pole. Like I told you, she's a strange dog. Strange dogs get strange haircuts. Okay, so we have our poodle tail ready, and I'm just gonna cut in a vertebrae right here. I usually have the treat bag on the table, but when I'm super focused on her back end, Candy will dive in and steal them. Very clever. So that's our first ring around. We'll try to make the second one around the same length. It's okay if they're not perfect. Again, this is a living animal. We're not looking for perfection, really. We're looking for something fun for both of you. If anyone's wondering how I dye her, she keeps laying down. Tune in to the next live because I'm going to be painting her. Once you have your little vertebrae in, you're going to comb it kind of like you would a poodle tail. You comb it downwards and then you just trim around. Like I said, you could choose the length. It's not the most detailed yet because you'll have to carve into it a bit more later. But as long as you have the roughing in, you'll be able to play with it as much as you want. This I'm going to try to make into a bit of a triangle point because it is the tip. Always make sure you're holding on to that tip of tail before you cut down with the scissors. It could and likely will result in amputation if you do cut the tip of a tail. Always, always go to the vet if there's an injury. It's not something you want to mess around with. For those of you that don't know, I am a certified pet first aid instructor with Walks and Wags, and I am a certified behavior consultant for canines with Dog Shop. And you can usually just look them up, find an instructor near you. Dog Shop did just open in the UK. Congratulations to Gabby and Shannon. So if you're interested in learning a lot more about training to add to your grooming, definitely look them up. I highly recommend. When she went to the vet 3 weeks ago, they shaved all the way up her tail, as you can see. That's okay, we'll just work around it. Groomers are always wondering why vets shave so much off of the animal. Pretty sure it's because they just want to make sure the wound stays clean. They've done some hideous things though, that's for sure. Okay. Even when Candy relaxes, her tail's always. It never actually relaxes. Gabby, the behavior teacher, has a video of Candy sleeping with her tail completely up and curled like this. Like I said, she's not a normal dog. For down the back, you might want to make sure you have the other side cut out, just to get a more precise cut, but for all intents and purposes, I'm just going to jump into it. Either way, I have about this much space to mess up on the other side, so it'll work. So you want to carve some comb downwards. And then with your 40, go in and touch. And if we're going about 2 thumbs thick, you can measure it like that, or you can use your comb. A lot of people use their combs, maybe not my half moon comb, but a straight comb you can use, and just know exactly where to cut if you choose to do it that way. Things because I'm crazy. If you want to be super meticulous with your design, try to line up the spine with the ribs, because naturally the spine is there and then there's cartilage and then there's rib cage. But that's up to you. You can just wing it. You can make half a skeleton if you want. It doesn't have to be perfect. As long as your dog's happy and you're having fun. I do tend to use my clippers a lot. Candy's a very still dog. She doesn't anxiously pant, she kind of just sleeps. So I can easily pass with my clippers and it doesn't cause any unwanted dents anywhere. To make them precise, you could carve upwards a bit and they just disappear. Okay, hold on. I'll make this line a little more dramatic here so that I see it. I don't know if you guys can see that, but I just put lines in so I know where to cut. And then I'll take my straight shears and just trim. Like I said at the beginning, she's about an inch long. Last year I did it at half an inch. It was a lot easier to maneuver, but you have a lot more space for error with longer hair. Shorter hair, you kind of have to be more precise. And that's her little back. And then you could just round them out as you go. Remember that the more vertebrae you put, the more you're going to have to paint. So if your dog's not super tolerant and has a short attention span, like they're good on the table, they're happy to be groomed, but 2 full hours of carving is a little too long, maybe space them out a bit more like I did with the tail so that you don't have as much to paint later on, because they really don't enjoy being wet for super long time. You just kind of paint it and feed them a ton of treats, and that's how you work your way around it. Kenny, catch. Turn her around like that. Good girl. Good girl. And you should just film the top of it. Dog hair all over me. So from the base of the tail, I did it a bit wider. I'll clean it up later, but for now it'll stay like that. And we'll just do the other side too. Again, follow the actual rib cage of the animal. It helps a lot to be as anatomically correct as possible. And if you make one side a bit smaller or off by a little bit, you can always, like I said, this is just the roughing, and you'll go back and tweak it to make sure it's around the same length and around the same size and the same height. That's a later project. Oh.
often thinks touch means touch my face with your tongue. Okay, we'll do 6 more minutes, and then we'll tap out because Candy's getting really excited. Yeah, I don't think she gets tired. I think she relaxes, and then she explodes of excitement. Again, you can bend the knee to find where the kneecap is, or you could just feel for it. You'll feel for it on the other side. It's right there. So this little section here, we're going to aim towards that. There is a flank here, so when you're shaving, be sure you know what you're doing and where you're going. It's very easy to cut that little piece of skin.
She's missing a kneecap on one side. She's searching the table for more food. So it's the exact same like you did on the other side. The tendency to use my hands a lot. You should use your comb. It's a good habit to start picking up your comb and really using it all the time. The more you touch fur with your hands, the more your hand oil goes into the fur, the less fluffy and soft and manipulative, the less you can manipulate it. So I did put her knee a little too high. Okay, we'll just cut this bone here. This is where her kneecap was supposed to go. We'll just try and hide that. As long as you haven't carved it in with your clipper, you should be able to just comb the hair and kind of push it aside. Once the clipper part is carved in, it's kind of permanent. You'll always see the dent there. You can definitely comb some hair over it, but every time the wind blows or the dog shakes, it's going to show. But again, perfectionism doesn't really matter as long as you and the dog are having fun. And when you get down to it and you are, always focus on your dog and your dog's behavior. I know Candy super well. When she gets excited and starts to jump and lick my face, it's time for her to get her zoomies out. And
that's it for her session today. I did procrastinate, so it is my fault. I'm so, so sorry. I didn't wash her until last night, and then I had to rewash her this morning. But with her skeleton do, she will not be peeing on her back legs anymore. And all of this, we'll clean it up later. It's just a rough in, like I said. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask them. You can also add me on Facebook, and you can follow my Facebook page, Pampered Puppers. You can use the code Skelepoodle for a 5% discount on OPAWZ. Buy any of their equipment, 5% off. Again, that's Skelepoodle. They also have a kit for the dye, paint pens, and curved shears if you want to purchase that. So, Candy's super happy that you joined us. Right, Candy? She's over it. Touch.
About people, they change.